It's an Eddie Bond special. It's, you know, he walks it down. And the beginning of it is almost like Sugar Hill, when you start on the high part. No, Fortune. Fortune.
Fortune.
Without hearing the fiddler, I couldn't even
play. Yeah. problem. Well, that's not the only problem with freeze. Another problem is different keys, bluegrass tunes, and Wade Petty doesn't play a real strong melody. He's got, like Eddie plays a good, strong melody. Wade Petty sounds good, but he's...
He got that bluegrass.
Bluegrass licks in there, right.
Runs.
And that really, it really sounds good, but, you know, if you don't know the tune to start with, you're in trouble.
I like to be able to hear the melody.
Yeah, me too. Hey, well, I'm going to get back home, I think.
There we go, over to the other side.
Huh?
You'll go over to the other side for a while.
The poor Helen, you know, she works every day. Pretty much, well, except for weekends. And beginning to feel like I'm abandoning her.
So she's getting along pretty good with that lady. She's a
single mother. Yeah. Oh, they love each other.
Mostly guys, mostly men. sleep.
That's
voice.
Probably true too. Yeah.
Now I think that is somewhat hereditary.
Probably.
Dyslexia meaning they can't. They see the words backwards and they don't see the.
They see the words backwards.
See the words wrong.
Yeah. Oh.
It's in the. It's something up here.
Uh huh. Now I can read upside down. No, she can't.
But I think you know, over time you overcome the dyslexia, or the school teaches you to. You can overcome it, but it's still something in the brain that is hereditary through the male.
Yeah, I think so.
I need to say my ABCs. This is fast backwards.
Well,
but I can't now.
Well, that's not exactly what this is. This is a vision thing.
Yeah, I know.
Well, see, I always consider myself a visual person, but what I'm looking at is the real world and mechanics and machines and things like that, but not words, you know, language.
Words are very tricky.
Okay.
I mean, like the written word is a huge, I mean, the ability to read to yourself is a huge cognitive step.
Well, one thing they had Helen do when she was in nursing is her teachers said, you need to read out loud to yourself when you're reading nursing stuff. And that way it gets imprinted somehow.
Because I had, you know, when I did technical stuff, I would go so slow. And now I read, when I read a book, I still read slow. And that's why I don't like to read novels and fun things. I like to read serious stuff because I've got to spend the time on it anyway. I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, I know. Melissa, she knows her reader. She gave me this book on strokes. And this lady had had a stroke. Did you read that book?
No.
This lady had a stroke, a massive blockage, and she recovered from it very, very gradually. And she said that as she started to come out of it, one of the last things that she was able to recover was the ability to read words. Uh-huh. She got all of her other movements and memories and things back. This was a different kind of stroke. It was a blood clot in her brain, an aneurysm in her brain that exploded. And she described how the stroke started, and then she described how she came out of it over a year or two.
Uh-huh.
But what she said when she first realized that what reading was and that she was supposed to try to do it, she said she thought it was the craziest thing that she could imagine.
You sure don't pick out weird stuff to read.
Melissa picked that out. You would be surprised at her.
No, I wouldn't, because she's another smarty pants girl. That's what I always call them in school.
But she reads, girl. Yeah. But this was a very interesting, I think I gave it back to Melissa. It's called My Stroke Insight.
One of the best books I've ever read is that thing on Jesus.
Yes, Melissa wants to read that.
Well, I'll get that.
If you can remember, bring it to her after she gets back from her trip.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway.
That's really allowed me to appreciate Christianity historically.
Yes.
And therefore philosophically. Because most of your modern Christians nowadays, they've got the language, they've got the myths, they've got all this stuff. But they're missing something.
But I found that I can deal with a lot of it. Now, some of it I can't. If I take it as a metaphor.
Yeah.
Try this. You think of God as the earth and Jesus as love.
That's the way That's the way I look at it. I figure that in the old days, they didn't know who God was and they certainly didn't know what nature was up to and all that.
Right.
And they invented metaphors to talk about these things.
And the metaphors are still very valid.
And they work.
Yes, they work.
If you know, but you got to remember they're metaphors.
Right. And I can do that. I've really learned to appreciate Christianity through thinking of those metaphors.
Right. But there really isn't a streets of gold, you know, and a throne.
I don't think that either. Right, yeah.
But I seen on the national news last night, I believe it was, that they found proof of where Jesus'
coming.
Yes, I think that's very plausible.
Because according to this book that you gave me to read, these guys were rebels, Jewish rebels, and they couldn't get along with the Romans, and they went around making trouble, and Jesus was a zealot, is what they used to call
him. You read that. You read two books since I've known you, and that was one of them.
No, I really enjoyed it. I'm going to read it again. But I'll bring it though, so she can read it.
Maybe later after Christmas or sometime. Yeah, after she get back from her trip.
And what's weird about it is the guy who wrote it was probably a Muslim.
Yes, right. That was interesting. Yeah. That was an interesting story.
And I'm wondering, this business lately, in North Egypt or North Saudi Arabia, the church that the ISIS shut up.
Yeah.
And they're Muslim.
Right.
And the church is Muslim.
Right.
But they're different denominations.
Yeah, yeah, they are.
Major branches of Muslim.
Yeah, they're different branches.
Yeah. Think about it. There was. Like the Catholics and the Protestants for a long time going through the same crap.
Well, sure. Yeah, that's right.
But these ISIS people, they don't even know what rage means.
They're pretty mean-spirited.
They kill for the fun of it. Cut people's head off.
It seems like that's true, yeah.
It's just like...
Run around and pick up trucks with guns on them, just kill whatever they can find. Seems like.
Just like somebody out here squirrel hunting.
Yeah. Seems like that.
If they see a squirrel, they're killing.
Well, we had trouble with the Muslims in North Africa, you know, that business. And of course, they're just running out of it.
Now, different people. They's good in people in all churches. There's good and bad people in all churches.
Yeah. Well, Muhammad was supposed to have been, well, really religious sort of fellow. But I don't know. Well, you guys, I'm a real party poop, I know.
We're going to go too. We had enough. I'm just so glad that I don't have to run every day. Stay home and enjoy some of the winter at home.
Yeah, that's exactly what we've been doing.
Yeah. I'm ready to just enjoy a few months of not running so hard. Bill will get bored. I worry about him being bored.
Well, we've got another Sunday jam.
Yeah.
Starting up.
Twice a month. Yeah, first and third.
Yeah, first and third.
Wildwood Farms up near Floyd.
Oh, well, yeah, I heard about that. That's a little card you gave.
It's singers. It's like the Friday jam out at the music center. They sing.
Oh.
They take turns singing.
Uh-huh.
But they're real native, natural singers, and they're enjoyable. They sing country by and large.
Uh-huh.
And they're very, you know.
Real Paul.
Yeah.
Well, if I never hear what's her face sings up at Fisher's Peak ever again, that's soon enough.
Who's that?
The guy, the fiddle player up there, and it's his wife, isn't it?
Dot.
Dot is good.
No. No, this is the one that, she mostly sings like stuff by, modern.
You're talking about Pat.
Pat, yeah.
I like Pat.
Oh, wow, she's likable.
I like her songs.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, the funny thing is, I hated Loretta Lynn. I can't stand her.
That's who she sings like,
yes,
yeah.
But when Pat sings it, it comes to me in a different way. I like it.
Huh.
It's weird.
Well, you're weird anyway. I figured that out a long time ago. You're not like anybody else.
Thank you.
And I know you probably appreciate that.
I do.
Yeah. I mean, when you figure, you know, you look at the books you read and stuff. Oh. I mean, they're really...
But I like people that sing from their feelings and that sing right in front of me. And, you know, don't have to be pretentious about it. Uh-huh. And I can do a wide range of music if that's the way they are.
Uh-huh. If they're really genuine.
If they're genuine.
Yeah.
And, you know, not too fancy.
Well, yeah, see, my problem is I was part of the folk craze. And looking back now, a lot of what I used to do was just... had nothing to do with the way I was brought up. It was just, you know, I was just...
Well, the folk craze got me into it too.
Yeah, I know, yeah. But maybe you went beyond that, you know.
Oh, no, I don't think about it too hard.
No, I wasn't growing up with the folk songs that much. I heard it, like on Nashville, Tennessee, or...
Well, the things I appreciated about the music around here is they weren't so much into singing because they were dance tunes.
That's good too, but I like singing too.
Well, it depends on who's doing the
most. You probably wouldn't like that Friday, that Sunday jam at the Wild March. You probably wouldn't like it. But people are enjoying the old time jam up at the country store. We have been to it. Downtown
Florida. Downtown Florida.
Yeah. It's a little bit farther.
Yeah.
And it's hard to park from there. We might go sometime.
Well, let me know. We might. Well, Helen, she's really dedicated to take care of this old lady.
Yeah. Well, if we do decide to go to the one uptown some Sunday, we'll call you and see if you want to ride over with us. It's like from 1:30 to 4, I think.
Right. It's Saturday?
Sunday.
Yeah,
it goes on every Sunday. Different people lead it. Mike McTrader leads it one Sunday.
He's pretty good, yeah.
But I think they just play one fiddle tune after another, and I can't keep up with it. But we might still go over and visit sometime.
Yeah.
But it has to be a fairly nice day because you have to park way up in the summer.
And park up around. Courthouse,
yeah.
And walk down.
I used
to stop
by. Yeah, I did that one time. I helped Mac Train perform one evening, but that's when we had the party. It was Jesse Lovell and Don Hill and myself. Mac Train was a dance.
Yeah.
But yeah, I remember we had to walk about three blocks. Well, knock on. Now that winter's here, we've got to reschedule ourselves and try to figure out.
After the holidays.
Yeah, the holidays.
The holidays are tricky.
Get them over with. Then we'll start getting together.
Yeah.
We've got two visits coming up this week. They're with new family and close people.
Well, family.
Major visits.
And I've got to be one of the wise men in. Christmas play.
Oh, yes.
The Christmas play. That's grade school stuff, you know?
It's a metaphor. It's good. It's all good if you think about it right. Most of it is. Too much of it can get bad.
Yeah. Oh, and yeah. I can put up with it, you know? I can appreciate it. Well, and they cast me in a complimentary way. I'm one of the wise men.
Yeah, I love it. I love that.
Tell that camera over there we need some help.
Okay, yeah, right.
Anybody out there, yeah, we need more musicians.
Yeah, of course. Last week we had them, and then this week we didn't. You never know.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm going to go sit after him, and I'm going to go sit in the other room for a little while.
I'm sorry, I'm such a poop.
Well,
but when you Heller's bought this new couch.
Oh.
It's looks like a side by side. What do you call them? Lounger.
Oh yeah. They're both of the. Yeah, we have one like that. They're both sides. The
kick up.
Kick up. Yeah.
And there we are. And we got an old. They're not called loungers. What are they called?
A recliner.
Recliner.
Yeah.
We got an old recliner left over next to this tandem recliner, and so the dog gets to sit there. So we're a family, you know, we're all lined up on our recliners. Oh dear. Yep, I know I'm getting older, I guess. These guys seem like they're having quite a bit of fun.